select the proper option for the following statements. In which of the following type of farming are the crops rotated? Option A, intensive. Option B, commercial. Option C, plantation. Option D, all of these. Correct answer is option A, intensive. Agriculture requires the following. Option A, only ploughing. Option B, use of animals, implements, machines and manpower. Option C, use of only manpower. Option D, just cultivate the crop. Correct answer is option B, use of animals, implements, machines and manpower. In India, agriculture has developed because option A, there are two seasons of agriculture in India. Option B, majority of the people depend on agriculture. Option C, traditional agriculture is practiced in India. Option D, in India, factors like climate, soils, water, etc. are conducive. Correct answer is option D, in India, factors like climate, soils, water, etc. are conducive. It is necessary that modern methods and technology be used in agriculture in India because option A, there are factories producing improved seeds. Option B, there are industries producing fertilizers. Option C, population is growing and there are agro-based industries. Option D, modern means and machines are available. Correct answer is option C, population is growing and there are agro-based industries. Few short answers for the following questions. Describe the importance of irrigation for agriculture. Irrigation means the process of supplying of water through artificial means such as pipes, canals, sprinklers, etc. Irrigation helps the farmers to be less dependent on rainwater for the purpose of agriculture. Since monsoons are uncertain and highly variable, farming cannot entirely depend upon rains. Hence, irrigation is needed to grow assured crops and also to grow crops in the months after the monsoon season. Give a comparative account of any two methods of irrigation. Well irrigation, canal irrigation, drip and sprinkler irrigation, tank irrigation, etc. are various methods of irrigation. Wells and canals have been used for irrigation since ancient times. Well irrigation. In this type of irrigation, a well is dug in the ground from which groundwater is taken out for irrigation. The area required for digging wells is less. It is a cheap, dependable and popular method of irrigation in India. Canal irrigation. In this type of irrigation, dams are constructed on rivers and water of the river is stored in the reservoir. The stored water is then supplied to fields with the help of canals. Canal irrigation requires vast area for construction of dam as well as constructing network of canals. Canal irrigation is dependable but costly method of irrigation. Mention the major types of farming and give information about intensive farming and extensive grain farming. Types of farming, subsistence farming and commercial farming. Subsistence farming is divided into intensive farming and shifting cultivation. Commercial farming is divided into extensive grain farming, plantation farming, market gardening and horticulture. Intensive farming. Getting maximum production from a minimum area is the characteristic of intensive farming. Due to large population or limited availability of land, per head holding is small. This type of farming is mostly seen in developing regions. Farm production is sufficient only for the requirement of the family. In this type of farming, the cultivator and his family are totally dependent on farming. As farm production is low, the economic condition of the cultivator is also poor. Extensive farming. Farm size is greater than 200 hectares. Due to large farm size and sparse population in the region, this type of farming is carried out with the help of machines like tractors and crushers. Pesticides are sprayed with the help of helicopters or planes. Monocrop or single crop cultivation is the striking characteristic of this type of farming. The crops are wheat or corn. Besides these, barley, oats, soybean are also cultivated to some extent. Heavy capital investment is necessary for this type of farming. since huge expenditures are needed for the purchase of machinery, fertilizers, pesticides, godowns, transport cost, etc. The problems in extensive grain farming are droughts, attack by pests, locusts, etc., and market fluctuations. This type of farming is carried out in the temperate grassland regions. Describe the characteristics of plantation farming. Farm size in plantation agriculture is 40 hectares or above. As plantation agriculture is practiced in illiterate tracts, use of machines is not possible and hence local manpower becomes important. The crop for which the geographical conditions are favorable is planted. This is a single crop cultivation practiced too. This type of agriculture does not produce food grains. Only commercial crops like tea, rubber, coffee, coconut, cocoa, spices, etc. are planted. This type of farming began and spread mostly during the colonial period. It is practiced in the tropics. Which are the crops cultivated in your area? What are the geographical reasons for that? I live in the Konkan region of the state of Maharashtra. The main crops cultivated in our area are mangoes, rice, coconut, cashew, etc. Konkan region has hot and humid climate, heavy rainfall, which favors the growth of these crops. This region has fertile laterite soil, which is suitable for cultivation of fruits. Why is the agriculture in India seasonal in nature? What are the difficulties for perennial agriculture? Most of the agriculture in India is dependent on monsoon rainfall. 80% of the rainfall in India is received from southwest monsoon winds from June to September. Since monsoon in India is seasonal, agriculture in India is also seasonal in nature. Difficulties for perennial agriculture. Rainfall in India is highly irregular and uncertain. Also, there is lack of irrigation facilities. There is lack of capital investment, godowns, transportation, etc. There is lack of awareness with respect to scientific methods of crop cultivation. Use your brain power. Why does extensive commercial farming need more capital? Farm size is greater than 200 hectares. Due to large farm size and sparse population in the region, this type of farming is carried out with the help of machines like tractors and crushers. Pesticides are sprayed with the help of helicopters or planes. Since huge expenditures are needed for the purchase of machinery, fertilizers, pesticides, godowns, transport cost, etc. So extensive commercial farming needs more capital. Why does plantation farming need skilled and experienced labor? Farm size in plantation farming is 40 hectares or above. Plantation farming is practiced in illiterate tracts, so use of machines is not possible. Hence, plantation farming needs skilled and experienced labor.